Well, mining giant BHP has cut its dividend after reporting a 24% drop in profit due to iron ore, lower iron ore and copper prices. Joining me now is our business reporter, Edward Boyd. Ed, iron ore prices dropped 25% during that half year, so naturally BHP took a hit.
Look, the simple fact is with any mining company, when commodity prices are lower, they make less money. BHP still made a lot of money during the half year. You can see their profit. It was $6.5 billion, down 32%. Revenue, almost $26 billion. Dividend, it's 90 US cents per share, which is still a really high dividend. But this time last year, it was $1.50 US a share. So during that half year, iron ore prices were down 25%. Copper prices were down 19%. And just to give you an idea, with the iron ore in particular, it cost them $15.50 US to produce a ton of iron ore. They still sold it for $85 a ton. So they still made a pretty big profit on every ton of iron ore that they sold. Look, here's a short grab, Laura, from the chief executive, Mike Henry, who spoke just a short time ago.
The metals and minerals that BHP produces are critical to the world and the future. To continue to prosper and to achieve the energy transition, the world is going to need more copper and nickel for electric vehicles, solar panels, and broader electrification. It will also need more iron ore and more of the highest quality metallurgical coals to make the steel needed for urbanization and decarbonization infrastructure, and will need more potash to support more sustainable farming.
Ed, I love the music. Is that meant to soften the blow? What's the hit to the dividend, and how is it justified?
Look, the dividend is down pretty substantially. It's gone from $1.50 down to 90 cents. But if you watch more of that corporate video that they put out, the chief executive said the dividend is still really high when you look at, you know, the previous few years. And we will actually have the chief executive, Mike Henry, will be on Business Hour later today, chatting to Ross Greenwood about all that sort of stuff.
OK, he doesn't need to bring his own music. That's fine. Ed, let's talk about supermarket chain Coles. It's lifted its profit and appointed a new chief executive, the first woman, I think, in its history.
Yep, first woman in more than 100-year history, Leah Weckert. She has been appointed chief executive. She starts on the 1st of May this year. The current CEO, Stephen Kane, he's been there for 5 years and he's retiring. But Miss Weckert, she's been at Coles since 2011, back when it was owned by Wesfarmers. She's had a range of roles at Coles, including chief financial officer and head of people and culture. So I think this is a great appointment for Coles. We can actually put up their profit results today as well for you, just to show Coles, like other supermarket chains, have done pretty well. Profit up 17% in the half, revenue up substantially as well, and they managed to lift their dividend. But there's one little snippet in their results of some good signs that we're starting to see a reduction in fresh food prices. So fresh produce prices are starting to come down in this new year. So over the last couple of months, they've definitely seen a reduction in price. So it basically means inflationary pressures are starting to ease off. But let's be clear, Laura, prices are still going up. They're just not going up as much as they were before.
OK. We want to see deflation just a little bit, do we? I mean, we saw that in BlueScope.
We'd love to see some deflation. Yeah, we saw in BlueScope they've obviously had to cut their prices significantly, and that is a sign of deflation in the economy. And hopefully we can see more of that over the next couple of months.
Yeah.